Hey guys, this is the Rifleman, and I'm here to carry on with my, provinces out of play. So, just to recap where we were, I'm currently at war with Spain and France, which kind of sucks, because I don't really want a major war with both of them. But I have managed to consolidate my regions in South America and in the Caribbean. I intend to take this army along to take Cayenne, then Martinique, then Caracas. I want to take Caracas, this ragtag army down here, which is an army I've had since the start of the game, will go on and start island hopping and taking the Spanish islands from them, whereas a new army will be raised here to move up through the continent. So, let's see. Ooh, dropping. Oh yeah. I did a bit more research on tax and well, not tax, trading more really. So I'll go back to here. You can see this port, this town, is labelled as wealthy compared to, well, this one's marked as wealthy. Oh, they're all wealthy, so that kind of defeats my point. I'll talk about farms then. Their output does depend on what kind of yield. For example, both of these are abundant yields, so they will both put out more money than, say, low yield farms. And it's the same with plantations, I think. You can have bad yields, like this one. Yo, low yield sugar plantation, which puts out 18 loaves of sugar. And this one should 30. Two small sugar plantations, but because this one has a high abundant yield, it puts out much more sugar. And one thing I'm going to say about trade, at the moment I'm reliant on two commodities. I'm going to get some ivory soon from my fleet in the that was taking out spices. Now it's going to go for ivory, but ideally I want to have as many commodities as possible because the prices can fluctuate so much. So you might say, okay, the highest is ivory, let's just go ivory. That's not how it works. If you just go for ivory, the price can really, really plummet. And then suddenly your economy, because it's a trade-based economy, has gone from a really wealthy economy to a really low economy. So it's best to have a variety, and it's just more interesting just having a variety of stuff. So let's head over to India. Where's my fleet? Where's my fleet gone? Oh, I assume my trade fleet is still kind of transiting either this entrance or this exit. I can't remember. Gotta remember to upgrade this settlement because it can make a lot of money. Right now, it's shrinking. Enlightenment technologies is helping. So, what do I want? 1% bonus region tax income. Plus 2 per town wealth. I think I'll go for this. And no, I can't upgrade roads yet. So, research. Right now, still working towards getting fire by rank as soon as possible. At Utrecht, how do you say it? And then Den Haag is working on physiocracy, and then we'll end up in empiricism, so I can upgrade my college. But this is mainly the route I want to go down. This is all is useful stuff, like technology research rate and town wealth and stuff, but this is more, these are more trade-based technologies. I'm considering I'm a trade-based economy. That is worthwhile. National summary. See, I'm still getting a significant proportion out of trade compared to tax. I'd like it to be the other way around, but get you in there. I'm not sure. Okay, well, let's end turn and see how that goes. Kind of reluctant, Spain in Europe. Next turn, I really, really, really might try and see if I can get away with a peace treaty with France. Of course, after I take this region right here, because that's an incredibly wealthy region. And ideally, if I take the Windward Islands as well, I'll knock them out of the Caribbean. And then won't have to worry about them again. Spain. Oh. Okay. Spain, I will keep attacking because they take up most of the regions in this part of theater, so I can't. There's not really an option to not go. Bane gets subsumed into. So that's. It's not like I can suddenly make peace with Spain, because New Spain, which owns, you know, Panama, Mexico, that whole area, will. Ooh. No. They will become. So there's no point trying to create a ceasefire with them. Okay, let's go down. Not really worth fighting, so I'll have to resolve this. Excellent. Then replenish. Gold mine. Love gold mines. Look at that, it's 1800 region wealth. This is the reason why these two are particularly wealthy nations, because they have mines. This one, gem and gold mines. This one has spices as well. So if you look at my... There you go. I am now trading spices from America. The sugar reduction comes from the Spanish blockade in my port. Infrastructure. Let's move Union Militia into this port. Yep. Fleet arrive. Aha! Who is this? Fifth rate. Uh-oh. Okay, well, let's go over here and stick close together. So how it works is that one... When you put a trade ship on a node, it extracts a certain amount of resources. The first one... It works out like the law of diminishing returns. The first ship extracts the maximum resources. The second one added on doesn't. So it kind of works out that, say, if the first ship extracts 20, I don't know, bales or whatever, the second ship will extract 17. So it's these ways to bear in mind. It's not just kind of two ships produces twice as much, because that's not it. Structure. There we go. I'm getting more trade output because now I have these sugar plantations. Trade is increased by, what was it, 2,000-ish, just from getting these ports up. Well, not obviously now, spices down here. But if I can take Martinique and then try barter peace with the French, that would be ideal. Okay, end turn. There doesn't seem to really be a dominant faction in India yet. That will occur, and it will most probably be the Maratha Confederacy. So, generally, if I'm playing as a nation which doesn't get involved in India, a trade agreement with the Maratha Confederacy is very, very good, because if you don't end up declaring war on them almost ever, then you end up... Oops, just a sec. You end up getting trade bonuses. It's like the longer you have a trade agreement in place, for having it in place for that length of time. I'll check my trade stats. Go with me. It probably has, but no. Tens of gold, something like that. It's not particularly big. So, I don't know why my computer's taking... so long to shuffle around. Once nation out, then it should speed up massively. You've still got nations like Louisiana and New Spain, which just won't exist. Okay. Election results. Check my... What do you do? Navy admin. We are both good Navy admins. Boot. There you go. If they're 4-star and above, they contribute positively to your stats. Recruit militia. There's no point in repairing the port yet, because they might just pop over and cancel it, and it's just a waste of money. Ooh, Russia has taken a region which allows them to trade here. So let's see if I can get that in. Russia. unfriendly, and either I or they don't have the proper amount of... don't have the space in their trade ports to allow that to happen. Like, every port offers a certain number of trade routes. I think it works out this port is worth 2. Then every single... no, that's not how it is. The one before this, the tier 1 port, is worth 2. And then every upgrade onto that adds an extra trade route. So I've only got... I've got 3 at the minute. So let's... head over... what have they got? Just nothing, and I've got these guys. Let's lay siege to them. Head over here. Get them ready on boats. Minus 1 militia unit. Well, actually, I need to wait for them to replenish. Get the militia unit in there. They still don't like me. They'll probably be... oh, look at that mining income. And that growth. Add some government buildings. Once you get to a certain level of government building, I think it'll be this one. Once you get this one, the next upgrade, you can either... you end up at a point where you can either pick to upgrade to a military barracks or a governor's residence. And the military barracks is good if you've got a nation which you plan on being your forefront. Hang on. Yeah, that should be fine. Probably got a process running in the background. But yeah. Like, this region has a military governor's barracks. So I produce troops, but I get less repression bonuses and tax bonuses. Compared to... aha! Perfect. Governor's residence. Military governor's barracks, plus 1 repression, plus 3% bonus tax. Plus 2 repression, plus 9% bonus. And most of the time, it's worthy just picking... the government building for the economical benefits. Can I? Yes. Okay. Well, Great Britain has claimed the 13 colonies, although they don't own Quebec. Why is it doing this today? Just a sec. Okay, guys. Brief computer screw up, but all that's happened is just reset me back to not moving my army here. So, I think this is an end turn. It'll be interesting how the power plays work in Europe, because usually it can change. Sometimes you get Austria as a dominant faction, sometimes Poland, Lithuania. Very occasionally you get Russia doing anything. Usually they go to war with Sweden, and it's usually back and forth between them up in that area. But never really much of an issue. I need to make good trading relations with the Ottoman Empire. They're a big faction, which anytime soon, because I'm meeting them. So they can be a good long-term trade partner and worth a lot of money. The bonuses themselves can be worth thousands and thousands of gold a turn. So it really does make a difference, but until you get bigger, to it's kind of like you don't need trade. It's good to have, but it gets to a stage where it's just not important. Let's get some militia going on. Ah, this is where we got up to before. Back with that guy. Yeah, it sorted out now. It was really laggy, but upgrade infrastructure. Still replenishing troops. Infrastructure. I think my next move is going to be capturing this island, which isn't going to be any problem at all. They didn't really protect these areas, so it's not a problem. Ooh. Not exporting some sugar. Oh no, predicted sugar. Right. Trade. Not trading with the Ottoman Empire, so let's get at it. Unfriendly, I don't have the capacity in my home port to do it. Excellent, so is this the one that upgrades ports? No, that's the next one, I think. Brilliant, okay. Not a problem. It would just be nice to have a concrete trade. Just try and maintain good relations. The Ottomans are allied with Austria, so if they declare war, if they haven't yet for some reason, then Austria will probably try to get me involved, which would suck, and I'll just cut Austria loose. They're all the way across the way in Europe, so what they do isn't really that much of a problem. All these small little factions that don't actually do anything, like the Knights of St. John, that just sit there on Malta and just do nothing. Interesting though, kind of, but there we are. Once we get to fire by rank, I'll be much more confident of fighting in Europe. Because right now, not great. Okay. So I can get militia in the ports to stop them from being blockaded all the time. Repair. So now if they blockade them, they'll just sit outside. They won't actually do any damage. Okay, printing. Oh gee, aha. Technology advances, so I can upgrade my plantations. It's £31 of spices. Okay, let's have a look at prices. Well, spices are obviously the best one to upgrade first. Then, because this region is just particularly wealthy, just keep their production going. These islands are not so much, because they only have one plantation each. The regions like Cuba, which have several plantations of different kinds, like coffee, tobacco and stuff, which is really interesting. Really looking forward to taking them. This army is replenished, so take all them. Scratch one. Actually, why don't I shift my navy over here? Then do it. Much easier. Come on. There you go. Ooh. Army. Oh, they're all militia. Right. Alright, I'm going to fight this guy, so I will see you on the campaign map. Okay guys, welcome back. This army is just militia, so not going to be a problem. Because we're a combined force, but just in case. Don't get screwed over by battle AI. By auto-resolve, rather. Come on. Okay. Looks like they're running up the way. So I'll make my guys run to meet them. Whoa. Stop. Space bar. Well, I can't remember what I pressed actually. Do that. All I know is I never want to do it again. Ideally, they'd be spread out more, but that's fine, I guess. Actually, no. Spread out. Because you don't have fire by rank, you're more dependent on the front ranks to actually do the damage, so you may as well spread them out as wide as possible, just to get as many guns firing at once as you can. Move up. This time walk, because they're not going to meet me. I am the attacker. Just make one of you guys split off this way. Falling back again. Run up. There we go. Ooh, look at these guys. It is a great looking game. No artillery upgrades, which would be nice. Canister shot. But once I got fire by rank, that'd be the next thing I work on. Artillery! Oh, God. Why do they do that? Yes, I sent a defensive line all the way back here when we're already outnumbered severely. That sounds like a great idea. Move up my militia. Artillery concentrating fire. Go get him, cavalry. Cavalry. militia armies. Just hope my general doesn't die. That'd suck. For a freaking militia. But we should be good, I think. They're dying faster than we are, so. Move up. Ah, crap. Okie dokie. Who's waving over here? God, I hate militia. How can you do anything useful? Apart from kill my general, it seems. Come on, return fire. Kind of. Just my provincial cavalry this time. General advance. I hate when the game does that. So that's not where I told you to go. Onwards, pikeman! This guy's gonna get it. Yeah, they're done. fire. That's all you can do on this game towards the end. In the battles, just keep moving. Try not to be static. Do some cavalry charges. They're always fun. Xenoros, my general. Fighter ranks to be so awesome. They're broken. Should be simple job. Now, there guys aren't going to stand. These units may as well move up to here to get to work on the other last unit of militia. And everyone else can as well. The remains of my general unit just slaughter their units. Being well would, wouldn't you? You would stop routing. General unit's already dead, so there's no point trying to kill the rest of my general unit because they're a cav unit, but that's about it. Really, really, really not much to say in this instance because it's just fighting militia. No tactical decisions to be made. Didn't even have bayonets. Provincial cav, that's fine. Where's my general? Up and at him, general. You can't withstand my militia. Whoop whoop. Captured it with a general unit. Epic. Never knew you could do that. Never knew that was a thing. Glitches for the win. Come on. One guy. Epic. You know what? Screw it. They don't have bayonets. Let's do this. Epic. Them go. No contest, game over. Well, it was always going to be because it was just militia, so. Best thing about this game, when they pair off. Watch this guy, what's he gonna do? He's done. They're all done, really. Okay, end battle. Okay, I'll see you guys back on the battle screen. Okay, here are the battle results. Lost 271 guys, killed over almost 1300. Who killed the most? And cavalry, as per usual, the sweeper reps. I don't really use cavalry a whole lot. I just, they're for mopping up for me rather than doing any serious work, which is kind of screwed, but I prefer to let my infantry do most of the work. Ooh, research. So, while this is building, we may as well research carbines and square. Let's head back to the Netherlands. can't build the drill school yet, but that'll be it. Okay, well, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next part.